Hello, GCC. This is Dr. Kim, and I'm here to teach you how to use your solubility rules from your Kim 130 periodic table. So the solubility rules, first of all, are for ionic compounds only in water. So these are not good for covalent compounds, and they're not good for solvents other than water, like, say, ethanol or acetone. So ionic compounds in water. The rules start with number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which are generally soluble compounds, unless there's an exception, which is the word but. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 are generally for insoluble compounds, again, unless there is an exception, which is the word but. So, for example, if we are going to look up a compound such as NaCl, we are looking for Na or Cl, whichever we come to first. Rule number 1, there is sodium right there. So these are always soluble. So NaCl is soluble. Notice I do not keep looking for rule number 4, which is for Cl. You stop at the first rule you come to. They are in order of importance. So rule number 1 trumps rule number 4. Now when something is soluble, it gets an AQ after it. AQ means dissolved in water. For ionic compounds like sodium chloride, it means dissolved and ionized or dissociated in water, depending on what the substance is. So in this case, it's actually broken apart into Na plus and Cl minus ions. Now, let's try another one. AgCl. So we are looking for Ag or Cl, whichever we come to first. Rule number 1 is for lithium, sodium, potassium, and NH4+. Rule number 2 is for acetate, C2H3O2-, nitrate. And then rule number 4 has Cl in it. It's also for Br and I. So this rule number 4 is a little confusing. It's for Cl or Br or I compounds, and they are soluble unless the Cl, Br, or I is bonded to, the Cl, Br, I is bonded to silver, mercury, or lead, in which case it's insoluble. So actually this is silver. So silver with a CLBRI is insoluble. Insoluble means it does not break apart. In fact, it stays solid, S is for solid, and it precipitates down to the bottom of a beaker. So NaCl would look like this, the Na and the Cl floating around in water. AgCl would look like this down at the bottom. Now I have 6 compounds I want you to try on your own. I want you to hit pause and tell me if these are soluble or insoluble and give them an AQ or an S according to the solubility rules. So hit pause. Welcome back. So the first one is lead to chloride, PbCl2. We're looking for lead or chloride, whichever we come to first. Rule number 4 has Cl minus in it, which is soluble unless it's bonded to silver, mercury, or lead. So lead is insoluble with Cl, so it gets an S. Barium hydroxide. We are looking for barium or hydroxide, whichever we come to first. Hydroxide is rule number 10. Hydroxide compounds are generally insoluble unless it's with calcium, strontium, or barium. We have barium, so it is soluble, so it gets an AQ, soluble. What about calcium carbonate? We're looking for calcium or carbonate. Rule number 6 is for carbonate, which is insoluble, no exceptions, insoluble means it's solid. Sodium sulfide. Sodium is rule number one. It is soluble. Therefore, it gets an AQ, as it will dissolve and break up into ions in the water. It is soluble. Magnesium nitrate. We're looking for magnesium or nitrate, whichever we come to first. Nitrate, rule number three, is soluble. Thus, it gets an AQ and breaks apart into ions in the water. And the last one, lead two sulfate. We're looking for lead or sulfate, whichever we come to first. Sulfate is rule number five. Sulfate is soluble except with calcium, strontium, barium, silver, or lead. Lead sulfate is actually insoluble, meaning it gets an S. All right, I hope this helps you with your solubility rules. Catch you in another video, GCC.